Hello, Salem. I'm your Mayor Chuck Bennett, and I'm really happy to be with you here today to share, I think, some great information from the City of Salem. Let's start with a couple of opportunities for community feedback. Yes, Salem, we need your help on and input on options for redistricting the city's 8 city council boundaries. The current alignment is outdated due to the growth of our city. I'd like you to join us for the November 8th virtual council meeting when the 3 alternative boundaries will be presented, or participate in one of the 2 virtual meetings on the topic in November 9th and 10th. Refer to the end of this video for more detail. We also need some input from Salem's business community. The City of Salem would like to better understand the needs and opportunities for local businesses, so a short survey has been developed. It's available using the web address which appears on your screen now. Lastly, the issue of homelessness in our city is of great concern to many residents. To keep community members apprised, the City of Salem has developed a special web page which provides weekly updates and allows you to submit your concerns about specific locations or garbage accumulation. Learn more at the web address below. Now, for this month's special guest, let's welcome Erik Andersson, the president of SEDCOR. He's going to tell us just what is SEDCOR, and what SEDCOR stands for, and why it's important to the economic development of our city. Well, Erik, again, thank you for joining me and talking about SEDCOR. But I think probably the best place to begin, because we use these acronyms so much and don't always what is SEDCOR?
It's a good question, Mayor. I worked in several environments where we had a dollar jar for when we had to say an acronym, so to try to cure us from that. SEDCOR is the Strategic Economic Development Corporation. Originally started as the Salem Economic Development Corporation.
Right, okay.
About 40 years ago. Next year will be our 40th anniversary. But we changed it to strategic to reflect our growing region. So, you know,
right.
we go into Polk County and Yamhill County, and in addition to Marion County.
So, but as I recall, you have you, who kind of deals with the entire region, and then each of the other communities have sort of their own SEDCOR office person.
Yes, yeah, we've got a team of business retention expansion managers.
Thank you.
Generally how we
say
refer
that
to
real
them.
Fast.
Yeah, BRE, another buck in the jar.
Excellent.
You know, their responsibilities are to basically kind of fill that role of an economic development resource for the communities that we work in. So, you know, they reach out to businesses, they work projects, they develop develop projects and bring partners to the table, you know, that type of thing. Really maintain those relationships with local businesses, traded sector businesses.
So I'm looking at coming to town, or I'm here in town, and I'm ready to either arrive, expand, locate, look at our makeup of our community in terms of the workforce. What do you guys do? What do you do for me as that business guy?
Well, first we sit down and listen. I mean, I think that's really the key, is just to identify if there's an issue or what the opportunities are, to really get a feel for where you are in the industry, where, you know, what types of resources you're looking for. We then generally work on a couple different levels. In some cases, if it's a new business coming into the area or a significant expansion, we bring everybody to the table at one time. These days, a virtual table. But we bring the finance folks together from the state and regional groups like the Mid-Willamette Valley Council of Governments. We also bring workforce partners, Chemeketa Community College, Willamette Workforce Partnership. We try to bring all those folks together so that the business can tell their story once.
Here's You're sort of doing. A one-stop shop for anybody. So Amazon comes to town. I assume Jeff Bezos flies in.
And yeah. Oh, yeah. He rang us up.
Yeah.
Texted
what,
us. Yeah.
What do you do when somebody calls up and says, we want to put in 1 million square feet and hire 1,500 people?
Yeah, it's interesting because it also depends on what their resources are. You know, a company like Amazon has their own economic development staff.
So oh, they, Okay.
Send people out. They know, they hire site location, you know, people on staff. They do a lot of this work in advance. So really for us, it's working with the local community.
Yeah.
Identifying what the needs are going to be. If, you know, incentives like the enterprise zone, you know, we try to work through those to see if they're applicable to the business and if they want to go through that process. But generally, it's that making the connectivity between that business and the various partners. We also get involved in a lot of the permitting, not necessarily directly, but just being sure that they understand the permitting process and understand what the to provide some certainty so they understand how long it's going to take and where there's opportunities to make it faster if they do things concurrently.
Who are you working with right now? I mean, I know there's these non-disclosure agreements and all that, but who are some of the folks you're working with?
Well, we have
right
some
now?
Local businesses that are expanding, which are pretty, which is always pretty exciting. We have a company that we're called, it was called Chang2. It's a Korean food manufacturer. They now go by Shinsegae, which is their corporate company name. They're a Korean business that has retail stores in Korea under that name. They're over off the Salem Parkway, and they're doing a major expansion, and I think we're looking forward to a grand opening of that early next month. They're doing a whole new line of food products there. They make food for, they sell it at Costco and other places. Yamasa, our soy sauce manufacturers here in town, and a lot of people don't know that we actually have local soy sauce. So, you know, when they go into the grocery store, you know, always try to buy local.
And it is Yamasa. That's
it's
what
Yamasa,
you look for.
Exactly. Okay. They are in an interesting position because, like a lot of businesses, they had a pretty mixed reaction to COVID and the pandemic.
Right.
Their restaurant business, you know, very quickly fell off, but people, you know, cooking a lot more at home, getting takeout, a lot of soy sauce was required. And, you know, we hear more than ever now about supply chain issues, but any of the Asian made soy sauce trying to get into this country is really difficult. So they've got a pretty unique opportunity now for an expansion there. And it's fun to work with the businesses that are already here.
So they're up, they've upped production and they bought more soybeans, or how does that work?
They are actually, for them, it's a fermentation business.
Yeah.
So they, interestingly, so in addition to wine and beer and distilled products, we have soy sauce here as a fermentation product. What they've done, one of the things that they're interested in doing was trying to figure out how to reduce their climate footprint, you know, their carbon footprint, and find local sources of product. And one, we don't grow a lot of soybeans in this region, but we do grow some wheat. So they contacted us and said, you know, is there a place where we can get red wheat? And we don't grow that kind of wheat in Oregon. But we have some pretty scrappy farmers in the region.
Yeah.
And we reached out to a couple, and the folks at Rudenclaw Farms in Yamhill County said, we'll give it a shot. And they actually grew 20 acres as a test plot, and it met the protein criteria, it met the moisture criteria that Yamasa required. So now they're growing 100 acres of wheat for them. So not only is it local soy sauce, but it's local wheat in that soy sauce as well.
Well, listening to you talk about it, it sounds like a really interesting job. I mean, I got to tell you, because it's so many different aspects, like where can I find red wheat and how do I find people at $20 an hour and to know how to run a forklift. I mean, it's like you've got a lot of moving parts. And one of the things the companies are going to face that are here or coming here is going to be dealing with climate action. Salem has developed its own very aggressive climate action plan. DEQ is soon coming out with the state rules with creating the state's climate action plan. At some point, I don't know when, obviously, I assume something will come out of Washington, D.C. that will provide us with guidance. What are you doing with all this? It really, I would assume, has a tremendous impact on
It certainly
business.
Can. I mean, I think it depends, you know, there's going to be opportunities in that as well as, you know, companies that need to change their way of doing business. I think for an organization like SEDCOR, one of our biggest, you know, responsibilities is getting good information out to the community and to our members that might be impacted by it. So that's been, you know, we were involved with the Climate Action Committee, and one of it is getting the information out that's coming from that group.
How are your folks reacting?
You know, generally, I think there's some concerns from the home builders, as you probably heard, as you know, as far as the natural gas side of things. Also, just from the perspective of a lot of the food processors and other businesses use natural gas in their production. So, you know, they're concerned about costs. It can be. I mean, and okay. I think the costs of conversion, you know, that's a cost that these folks are going to need to be looking at, and you know what the impacts are going to be to their incumbent electric company if you know they're looking to provide more resources too. So, you know, we'll certainly be keeping an eye on that. And it was funny, I think, that people, when they recognized the issue, a lot of it was very kind of a micro level. It was like, well, don't chefs like to cook with natural gas? I think that came up during one of the meetings.
That's one I've heard.
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, you multiply that out times food processors and, you know, you get a feel for, you know, how it is important in a lot of companies now. But we also see some potential opportunities. A company like Yamasa, I mentioned, you know, they're not importing wheat from the Midwest or from Canada now, so they're cutting down on their transportation costs. So that's going to help them in their carbon footprint.
Right.
That was something they were very much interested in doing.
Well, I guess finally, how do folks contact you that are, if there are folks watching that would like to kind of check in with SEDCOR, I have this project or I've heard about this project, or would like to just know more about what you do and be maybe a little more either informed or involved?
Well, probably the best starting point is our website, www.sedcor.com.
And that'll be on the run, I think, probably as you spoke.
Oh, good. Okay, there
yeah.
you go. But, you know, that has direct links to all of our team, depending on where they're located. But for if they just want to get an idea of what we're doing or some opportunities, following us on social media, we have a good social media presence, you know, better than we've had in the past. So we're excited about that, getting information
Great.
Out. Also, we have a monthly business forum that at this point we've pretty much transitioned to Zoom for the time being, and those are free of charge. So
okay.
if people want to register for that, you can get information on that on our website.
Okay.
But yeah, we're always anxious to talk to businesses that, you know, we tend to get a lot of attention for the recruitment side of things. You know, and Amazon is the one that gets the attention, and we are working with some exciting, you know, recruitment projects
we'll
right
now.
We'll
look forward to those in the
future.
But yeah.
it's the bread and butter of our business is the jobs that are created by, you know, folks that are already here and have already invested
right.
in Salem and in the community.
I really appreciate hearing that. Really appreciate you taking time with us and talking with the community and with me about what SEDCOR is. And is up to. So thanks
again,
Erik. Oh, we're
pleased to. We have a great working relationship with your team here at the City of Salem, and I think the community has a lot to be proud of as far as the really its business focus and how easy it is to work with.
Great. Thank you, Erik, very much. And thank you very much for joining us.